and culture. Definition: it's a screw cap culture tube partly filled with an agar mix, such as nutrient agar, R2A agar, or TSA. To make it a sand tube, the agar is allowed to cool with the tube laying at an angle, resulting in a large surface area for spreading a culture. Agar sands are used for storing pure cultures for a moderately long term. The steps. Firstly, obtain 3 nutrient agar sands. Number 2, using an inoculating loop and proper sterile technique, inoculate each of the previous colonies onto a separate sand. By looking at this picture, it shows a septic technique. So number 1, inoculating loop is heated until it is red hot. Number 2, cap is removed from the sand culture and tube mouth is heated. Number 3, organism is picked up from the sand with inoculating loop. Number 4, mouth of the tube is flame, the inoculating loop is not flame. And next, sand culture is recapped and returned to test tube rack. Number 6, tube of sterile agar sand is uncapped and mouth is flame. Number 7, sand surface is stripped with unflame loop in a serpentine manner. Number 8, tube mouth is flamed, recapped and incubated. And lastly, loop is flame red hot and returned to the receptacle. By culturing this technique, it is using a zigzag motion to spread the bacteria across the surface of the sand. Be careful not to penetrate the surface of the agar. And lastly, incubate sands for 48 hours at 37 degrees Celsius. These transfers may be used again in later labs.
Next, liquid nitrogen. What is liquid nitrogen? It is an inert cryogenic fluid with a temperature of negative 196 degrees Celsius that is commonly used in research labs. It will cause the culture to be freeze at or below negative 139 degrees Celsius, in which it will stop the growth of ice crystal and slows down the rate of biophysical processes. There are few types of microorganisms can be preserved by using liquid nitrogen. This includes amoeba, zygomycetes, oomycetes, phytopathogenic fungi, yeast, and other microorganisms such as ascomycetes that sporulate poorly in culture and higher basidiomycetes that only grows mycelia. This preservation method involving 5 steps. Firstly, the fungal mycelial and sporous suspension is pipetted in a liquid of 0.5 ml into sterile 2 ml screw cap polypropylene vials. The filled vials are placed into pre-labeled cans in racks that then are put into the freezing chamber of a programmable freezer and allowed to equilibrate at 4 degrees Celsius for about 10 minutes. They are then cooled from 4 degrees Celsius to 40 degrees Celsius at a rate of 1 degree Celsius per minute and from negative 40 degrees to negative 90 degrees Celsius at 10 degrees Celsius per minute. After reaching negative 90 degrees Celsius, vials are transferred immediately into liquid nitrogen vapor at negative 150 degrees Celsius to negative 180 degrees Celsius. Next, cultures are thawed rapidly by placing vials in a warm water bath with a temperature of 37 degrees until 55 degrees Celsius until the last trace of ice dissipates. Cultures in glass and pole and straw thaw in less than a minute, while those in polypropylene containers take longer. And finally, culture samples are then transferred aseptically to appropriate growth media.
Hi, the next preservation is short-term storage of dried culture in dehydrated form. The properties of dried culture storage is the bacteria suspension is placed in petri dish in forced air incubator for 24 hours at 25 degrees Celsius. The figure shows the properties of short-term storage of dried culture. There are two conditions, which is agar plate shrinking and step culture. Agar plate shrinking is for daily or weekly use. The shrinked agar must be stored at 4 degrees Celsius. The shrinked agar will be wrapped with plastic or sealed with paraffin. The agar then will be stored upside down. This is because to minimize contamination. Okay. For the technique of seed plate method, firstly, hold the bronze culture containing tube in left hand and shake it. Sterilize the wire loop of the inoculation needle. Next, remove the cotton plug of bronze culture tube by little finger of right hand. Continuous, flame the mouth of test tube immediately. Insert the wire loop to form a thin film and replace the cotton plug.
Next, the thin film in the loop is triggered in a zigzag manner by removing the loop backward and forward firmly. They incubate the petri dish in incubator at required temperature. Lastly, growth of the bacteria will be visible on the streaked mark.
Step culture. Step culture is quite similar to the streaking culture, but the culture is kept in a tube.
I'm going to present about cryopreservation methods. Cryopreservation is a process that preserves organelles, cells, tissues, or any other biological construct by cooling the samples to very low temperature. Cryopreservation is the use of very low temperatures to preserve structurally intact living cells and tissues for a long period of time. Generally, there are 8 steps of cryopreservation. The first one is the selection of materials. For cryopreservation, the selection of proper plant material is very important. Factors depend on it such as density and nature. Next step is the addition of cryoprotectant. The purpose of this step is to prevent microorganisms from damage during freezing, storage, and also during thawing process. 2 cryoprotectants should be used together instead of a single one as they are considered to be more effective. There are 3 types of freezing method. The first one is slow freezing method. A tissue or plant material is slowly frozen at slow cooling rate. The second one is rapid freezing method. The vials are plunged in liquid nitrogen. In this process, the temperature decreases from -300 degrees Celsius to -1000 degrees Celsius rapidly. Dry freezing method is a method where hydrated cells and seeds are stored. Next is the storage in liquid nitrogen. It is recommended that the vials be placed initially in -60 degrees Celsius for 1 hour and then transfer into liquid nitrogen at -196 degrees Celsius. A continuous supply of nitrogen is needed to prevent damage. The thawing process is carried out by plunging the vials into a warm water bath with vigorous swirling. It is also causes the vials to get transferred or moved to another water bath at 0 degrees Celsius. Next is the washing and reculturing. The preserved material is washed to remove the cryoprotectant. The material is recultured in a fresh medium. Next is the measurement of viability. Due to the storage stress, there is possibility of cell death. The presence of viability can be seen in many cases using formula number of cells growing divided by number of cells called times 100. Last but not least is the regeneration of plants. The viable seeds are recultured on a non-specific growth medium. Suitable environmental conditions are maintained.
Method of preservation of microorganisms in upstream process is freeze-drying method. Freeze-drying bacteria is a useful method for long-term preservation. It is also known as lyophilization or cryodesiccation, which is a low-temperature dehydration process that involves freezing the product, lowering pressure, then removing the ice by sublimation. The main principle involved in freeze-drying is a phenomenon called sublimation, where water passes directly from solid state to the vapor state without passing through the liquid state. The material to be dried is first frozen and then subjected under a high vacuum to heat so that frozen liquid sublimes, leaving only solid dry components of the original liquid. There are 3 phases involved in freeze-drying process, which are freezing, primary drying, and secondary drying. At freezing phase, the product must be frozen in a low enough temperature to be completely solidified. It can be done in the freezer, a chill bath, or on a shelf in the freeze dryer. It is very important in freeze drying to pre-freeze the product to below the intake temperature before beginning the freeze drying process. Next, at primary drying phase, the pressure is lower and heat is added to the material in order for the water to sublimate. The rate of sublimation of ice from a frozen product depends upon the difference in vapor pressure of the product compared to the vapor pressure of the ice collector. Primary drying can be a slow process. Too much heat can alter the structure of the material. Lastly, at secondary drying phase, after primary freeze drying is completed, the ideally bound water molecules are removed by raising the temperature higher. Finally, after the freeze drying process is completed, the vacuum can be broken with an inert gas before the material is sealed. Most materials can be dried to 1 until 5% of the residual moisture.